So let me show you one more example of render forest. Suppose I want this kind of video, whiteboard animation toolkit. So I'm selecting this and let us go on create now. And there will be many options available. I will load a preset one and these kind of animated videos will be there. You can make your own story, you can write a script and you can use the ready-made story. You can just add text here, whatever story you want to create, and you can change the sequence of the pictures also here. And just have a look at preview how it looks. So we'll go for free preview, and in free preview you can see this kind of video. And with help of this, you can publish this video. You can share it with your friends on Twitter, Facebook, any other social media. You can share it to my videos and you can download this. If you want to download, you can download, you can save on your computer and you can use this video whenever you want for the teaching learning purpose. So renderforest.com is one of the beautiful tool that all the teachers can use in teaching learning process. So let us go to the next part. I want to show you some tools from Google itself. So for this you need Gmail account. So open your Gmail account and here on this right hand side you can see some dots, some Google apps. And all these Google apps are very useful for school teachers. Nowadays many school teachers and college teachers, they are using Google Classroom for teaching learning purpose in this lockdown period. So let us see one by one. Here you can see Google Classroom. If I click on the classroom, the Google Classroom page will get open. This is one of the very important and useful tool. Here already I have created few Google Classrooms. So let me tell you, here right hand side there is a plus sign and create or join. If I click here, you will see join class or create class. If already class is created and your students want to join this, student can click on join class. But as a teacher, if you want to create class, click on this. So after creating class and accepting the terms conditions of Google, I click here on continue and you can see this page. So you have to give a name to your class. So I will give name to this class as Beer ICT. So this particular class is only for Beer students and ICT subject. Section I will write here A. I'll write full name of the subject, that is ICT in education. Room you can create here, and after creating the class, you will go to the actual page of the Google Classroom. So you will be able to see this kind of page. So this is the first page of my Google Classroom. Here Beer ICT A division, and here you can see this is a class code. I'll show you again. Here class code is there. If you click on display, it will get display like this. And what you have to do, you have to copy this class code and you can send to your students through email or on WhatsApp or by message. That with this class code, your students can join your class. So they just have to put their class code while joining. So here you can see select theme, upload photo. If I want to select the theme, or I can upload the photo if I already have some photograph on my computer. Here I'll click on select the theme, and as my subject is related to ICT, I'll select this theme and select class theme. So this picture will get changed. So you can see here the theme is changed, and here you can create and schedule announcements, respond to student post. If student post anything, you will be able to see here. Here you can see some options: stream, classroom, people and grades. Grades you will be able to see once you post some assignments and your students will answer, and you can give grades to students. In people, you can add some teachers and students. Here just click on the add, and you can type the name or email of a person, and that person will get added here. In classwork, here if you want to create any material, study material, if you want to give any assignment, quiz assignment, question, material, reuse, post, topic, all these things are there. If I click on material, you will be able to see this kind of page. Here you can write the title of your subject or sub point, description about it. And if I click on add, here again there will be four options. If already I have any material ready about my particular subject, I can add from Google Drive. I can add through link. I can actually attach the file if PDF file is there, if PowerPoint presentation is there. I can attach that file in the study material. I can attach through YouTube also. So these options are available. You can attach your files here, and you can put whatever material you want to put on this material page, and you can create the class. So this is one of the very beautiful tool that all the teachers can use. Here setting button is there, so you can change the setting if you want, general setting and grading. If you go on this, you will learn more, and my friend, this is one of the very useful tool. I am going in little hurry because I want to show you many other tools also. So let us go to the next part, that is Google Docs. Here you can see Google Docs. I like Google Docs because of one feature. I really love that feature. So when we go on Google Docs, this kind of page will get open. So already I have created some pages here, but we will create a new one. So we'll go on blank page. After clicking on blank page, this will look like a Word file. So all of you must know how to use Microsoft Word file. This is a version of Microsoft Word. So here all the options are similar to Word file, but the best thing here is, which I like, you can see all the options on clicking these menu bar. But the thing I want to show you here is translate document and voice typing. These are the best features of Google Docs, because if I want to type something in other language which I don't know how to type, for example, if I want to type in Marathi or Hindi, and this tool will help me to type in that particular language. I will show you how. So I will click on this voice typing. Here you can see one icon. Here language you can select, and just while speaking, click on this. So here English language is selected. So I will click on this and I will speak. It will automatically get typed here. Hello friends, today we are going to learn about ICT in education. So you can see all the material is ready with just a speaking. So, and there is not a single spelling mistake, you can see over here. For example, if I want to change the language, I want to type in Marathi. So I'll go to Marathi font. Let me check. Here it is. So again, my language Marathi is selected, and I will click here. Namaskar Mitranno. Aaj apan ICT ya vishayavar abhyas karnar ahot. You can see over here, I just said and that also got typed here. So after clicking on this, whatever you speak, it will get typed. So it is here. And you can select any language, and if you know that language, you can speak in that language, and all that content will get typed on this page. Suppose I want to translate this. So what I will do is, I will go to the tools and I will go on translate document. So I want to translate this document in Hindi. I will select the language Hindi here. So let me go to the Hindi language. Yeah, it's here. So you can just click on translate, and Google Docs will create another page that is called as translated copy. You can see over here both the statements are translated in Hindi. So Google translated English statement also and Marathi statement also in Hindi. So if you want to translate anything, you just use this and you can just copy this page and you can share with anybody. So if you click on share, it will ask you share on which email. So you can put email over here, or you can copy the link of this page and you can share through your Google Drive. So this facility is available. This is one of the beautiful tools I have ever seen. We will see some more features of Google Docs. If you click on this side icon of Google Docs, you will be able to see here Docs, Sheets, Slides and Forms. We will see the forms. All of you are familiar with the Google Form, and nowadays in lockdown period, we are using it very frequently. We will go on the blank sheet, and here you can create your form. If you want to give title, I will give title here ICT. Description, I can write here, this is for B.Ed. students. Okay, and I want to put some questions here. Suppose I will write here, what is e-learning? And automatically you can see over here, Google has given me option that what kind of answer it will be. So if I want it a short answer, I just want a definition of e-learning. And if I want to make it required, so mandatory question, then again I will go to this plus sign. I will show you these options are there. Plus is add question. This is import question. If you already have some questions ready in your computer, you can add those. Here it is. Add title and description to your page. Add image option is there. Add video and add section if you want to make two sections of this question paper. For example, if I want to add image here. Here you can see a picture. I will add image here. Let me check if any image is there in my pictures folder. So, okay. I will select this image and I will add this image to my Google form. So this image will get added here. It's little bigger. I will make it little small. So, okay. And we'll add a last question here, that name the person. Okay. So it will again give me short answer, or I can give multiple choice answers. I can give some options here. Checkboxes, drop down. File upload is available there, then linear scale, multiple choice grid, checkbox, date, time, short answer and paragraph. Okay. Again, I will make this question mandatory.